Ford Foundation, we are going to call them out and we are going to tell them if they are not interested in democracy in Kenya, if they are going to sponsor violence, if they are going to sponsor anarchy, we are going to call them out and we are going to tell them they either style up or they leave.
Hello, what's popping? Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel. I love you so much. Now, Kenyan President William Samoei Ruto has contradicted himself again. Let me tell you, once a politician, always a politician. This guy is far away from being a leader. He does not act as a leader. He does not know what his people want. He does not know what Gen Z want. Now, after the protest, everyone was looking who to blame. The leaders was looking who to blame. The vice president of Kenya, the deputy president was looking who to blame. And they came to conclusion that this protest was due to the anger of people, due to the hunger of people, due to the bad situation of people, and it led to Gen Z to protest. They came to conclusion that it was due to bad governance, corruption, and high cost of living that has led to this protest, of which is true. The youths of Kenya went on the streets because they don't have jobs, because we have imposed into high taxes, because everything is high, because there is no good health, there is no good education. Everything, every situation here in Kenya is so bad. And that's why the youths or the Gen Zs went in the streets. And that's why every African youths and every African citizen is willing to go to the street simply because we have bad governance. Now, recently, President of Kenya, William Ruto, have gone. He was in a rally, you know, and in certain market. And he said this.
And President William Ruto has accused the Ford Foundation, an American private foundation, of sponsoring violence during the anti-government protests witnessed across the country. The president, who was speaking in Nakuru County today, claimed that the American private entity hired goons to cause mayhem during the protest, which led to deaths and destruction of property. Citizen TV's political affairs reporter Emmanuel Toh has the details.
We want peace.
President William Ruto's allegations against the American-based philanthropic organization has kicked up a storm locally and internationally. The head of state was in Nakuru County Monday for a series of development tours, including opening of the Njoro Technical Training Institute and inspection of markets, firing at the Ford Foundation for allegedly funding the anti-government protests witnessed across the country.
And I want to call out those who are behind the anarchy in Kenya, those who are behind the sponsoring the chaos in the Republic of Kenya, shame on them, because they are sponsoring violence against our democratic nation. Mimi nataka niulize watu wa Ford Foundation watuambie hiyo pesa wanatoa ifanye fujo ndio wapate faida gani.
The president firing a warning shot at the foreign powers to stop interfering with Kenya's local affairs.
We are going to call them out and we are going to tell them if they are not interested in democracy in Kenya, if they are going to sponsor violence, if they are going to sponsor anarchy, we are going to call them out and we are going to tell them they either style up or they leave.
This is what Ruto said. And this makes me think that everything that we told him, everything that we thought that he knew, everything that we thought that he understand, he has deleted it. He doesn't get what we as the youths want. He doesn't understand us. Or rather, he's still a politician. He is not a leader. Now, he has been thinking who is sponsoring the Gen Z protest. And he came to conclusion that Ford Institution is the one that is sponsoring the Gen Z protest. Now, if there is someone sponsoring the Gen Z protest, if there is someone giving out money so that the protest can hold, I have not get my own share of money. You, Ford, you haven't given me my share of money because I was in the street protesting for the better government. That's so... I was to call it stupid, but let me not call it stupid. How can you say that this protest was being sponsored by some foreign institutions, some foreign organization, and yet we as the Kenyan people, we as African people, we are the one who knows where the shoes does not fit us? How can you say Ford organization, the foreign organization, is funding the youths to protest, and yet we are sleeping hungry? And yet we don't have good hospitals. We don't have medications in our hospitals. We don't have good educations. We don't have good roads. How can you say that? So, thus you're trying to tell us everything that we'll be saying we are going through as Kenyans, it is being sponsored by the foreign organization. Or is just you want to get someone to blame on so that you are supporters, the supporters who are supporting you. You know, there is some old people, the millennials, not millennials, there's some a set of people, they support everything that the president says. That's our parents. Or is just you are looking for who to blame? We as the citizens of Kenya, we as the youths of Kenya, I personally, Livingstone, the Kenyan beast, I'm going through a lot. The taxes are killing me. High cost of living is killing me. I cannot even afford $1 a day. I can't afford a dollar a day. And if I get that dollar, it does not help me. If I get $5 a day, it doesn't help me. It wasn't like this. The government that passed, it wasn't like this. We are suffering a lot. So you standing there at the podium in front of our parents and shouting and saying that the foreign organization is funding the youths to create chaos. That's so sad. Ford organization is an organization from USA. It was situated in Kenya since 1963. It has been in East Africa. Its offices opened first in 1963 in Kenya. So, if Ford is supporting or sponsoring the Gen Z protest, where were these Ford in 2017? Where was it in all those years? Why only in your regime they are sponsoring the youths to protest? Why only in your regime? Because Ford has been here in this country from 1963. It's an ungovernmental organization helping people and everything. I don't want to support. I'm saying that I'm supporting Ford. I don't know them too that much, but it is one of the wealthiest organizations, ranking at number 11 worldwide. It is in Africa, North America, South America, and Asia, running its business, helping people and all those things. But all I'm saying is, you saw the people who were in the street. The people of Kenya were more than 100,000 in the street. Each and every city, name it, Eldoret, your own place, Nakuru, Kitale, Bungoma, Vihiga, Nairobi, Kenya, Mombasa, Machakos, the youths were in the street. You can't tell me, Mr. President, all these youths who are being paid, who are paid by Ford organization. You can't tell me the youths of Eldoret who are paid by this organization. You can't tell me all 100,000 millions of youths who are being paid by this organization. You can't tell me the youths of Mombasa who are being paid by this organization to go on the street. Mr. President of Kenya, this story you are telling us, it does not add up. You have to deep more and more. Don't look far, because you are the one who is sponsoring this protest. You are the one who is creating all this anarchy. You saying anarchy, you are the one who are causing these criminals to be on the road. You are the one who are causing these people to be killed by the police because of how the country is being run. We thought you got what we wanted. We thought you understood what we wanted, but it's like you never understood. It's like Mr. President never understood what the Kenyans wanted. We wanted all the corrupt leaders out of the office. We want you to call the MPs back home. Let us vote for them again. We want you to fire all the parastatals, chairmans or leaders. We want you to bring back Linda Mama, bring back things that help Kenya, free education. Why on earth are Kenyans, every member of parliament has bursary, women rape has bursary, president has bursary, governor has bursary, all the money is calculated up to add up 830 billion shillings. Why don't you channel all that money to schools and let students have free education? So, when you stand there and tell us our protest is being sponsored by certain organization, we are feeling bad, Mr. President. We as the citizen of, I'm talking as the youth of Kenya, you don't know what you want. I'm talking for a million youths of Kenya who are in the streets. The youth does not have jobs. So, are you trying to say the Ford organization too is sponsoring the jobs? The other time, the government spokesman was saying it is the Russia who is sponsoring the protest, and your deputy president said that it's because there is a lot of problem in Kenya, that's why people are protesting. The Nurdin Haji, the CIA chairman, said that your deputy president and the former president are the one sponsoring, and you are saying it's Ford organization that is sponsoring this protest, these demonstrations, and where you are 1,000,000% wrong. You are wrong. The problem Kenyans are facing is the problem of all Africa. The problem Kenyan people are facing is the problem of Ghana, problem of Nigeria, of Zimbabwe, problem of a lot of countries. So, don't blame people for your mistakes. Don't blame people for the things you started. Don't blame people for the corruption that is going in 254. Don't blame people because we don't have for the high taxes. Do not. You are supposed to sit down as a leader, not as a politician. The way you did it the first 2 weeks when we did the protest, it was good. You were acting as a leader. Sit down. Look where there is loopholes. Come with strategy. Organize, and hit back again. Don't be a politician. Tell me what you think on the comment section. Do you think is it true that the protest of 254, the Gen Z protest, is being financed by a certain group of people, by a foreign? Tell me in the comment section what you think. I am the Kenyan Beast. Of course, we are doing it the African way every day, every time. Peace be with you.